about the sound of reggae that puts people in a good mood. I don't know what it is. It's the groove. It's the bass and the drums. It's just the vibe of this music. And a man who knows a thing or two about some great reggae music is live in the studio right now. Pitchers, nice to meet you, man.
Thanks,
welcome to the newsroom.
Yeah.
You know, I always talk about this because, you know, I'm a musician. And I generally play a lot of rock and roll and some funk and blues. But I find that reggae music is this universal sound, and it really doesn't matter where you're from, what part of the world. Something about reggae music gets into people's soul, puts a little bit of extra hop in their step. What is it, do you think, about this music that just connects universally?
Sometimes it's the message that's in the music,
mm-hmm.
and sometimes because it's got like grassroots, it talks about the people's struggle and mm-hmm. you know, and all these things that we, you know, and it kind of keep you in tune with your spiritual upliftment or growth. And the type of rhythm, the way the rhythm is, you know, mm-hmm. deep within you. So reggae music is captivating.
I always find that reggae music is almost kind of like a wave, and you just kind of ride in the wave. And waves have this nice, you know, this fluidity to it. Yeah. And it just, you just, once you get on the wave and get on the groove, you can't stop moving.
Yeah, just like that.
Exactly. I gotta tell you, I'm looking at, you know, your bio and the fact that it's been nearly 30 years since the first single
yeah.
was released.
Yeah.
Does that register? Can you believe that it's been 30 years since you released your first single?
Well, as they say, time flies. You know, I still
when you're having fun.
Yeah, definitely. So, you know, but I've been out there for a while, and mm-hmm. I enjoy a bit of it, and the fans show me great love. So they give me energy to keep going, mm-hmm. keep going and writing stuff.
What inspires you to keep writing? You know, a lot of artists, you know, after doing this for so long, they maybe hit those writer's block and they struggle to find something else to write about. What motivates you to keep writing?
That's everyday life, and you know, we see people's struggles, because sometimes we say things that we're not really facing, but someone else is facing that, so we can speak for the mm-hmm. that person, a particular person. So, you know, that motivates me to write. Like, take for instance, now, when I just started out, there wasn't any cell phones. Now there are cell phones. So, and but it becomes dangerous when you're driving and you're texting mm-hmm. and these things. So I've got this song called Pre the Road Alone,
mm-hmm.
saying, drivers hear my message. Mm-hmm. When they stop, check your message. That's just when they stop. Mm-hmm. See, when they drive, pre the road alone, put on the phone.
There's always an issue. There's yeah. always a social issue to
yeah.
tackle.
And then again, you have crime and mm-hmm. violence, which is every day growing and getting more strong and coming closer to home. So you have to kind of get the youth them mm-hmm. to know that which road they should take. Then you have a lovers issue.
Exactly.
You know, we have to kind of to bind the people some, mm-hmm. in terms of showing them, you know. And yeah. So you're just talking about people life.
Before we tell everybody at home where you're playing today and tomorrow, I love the fashion. I love the get up here, and I know that it's a big part of your life as well, right?
Yeah, well, definitely. Art is like a product, man. Yeah, so you have to advertise a product. Yeah, so I take pride in my appearance. Over the years, I just like to appear proper.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and you know, so I choose not to blend in with the crowd. I like to show myself as a star. So I try to have my designers. So when I started out with this designer called Biggie.
Mm-hmm.
So we went to Dean. So right now I'm working with Rick Bayless.
Cool.
Standing right over there.
Very cool. Listen, we want to tell everybody you're going to be performing today down in Centennial Park for Jerkfest today and tomorrow, in case you can't go by today. Want to thank you for coming on the show. And if people want to find out more about your music, is there a website they can
go to? Yeah, well, Pinchas Bandolier, Facebook.
Yeah.
Star Trek Reggae. Yeah, Instagram, Star Trek Reggae, Facebook. Yeah.
Thank you so much for stopping by. We're going to take a little Pinchas to break. We got more CP24 Breakfast coming up.